one's from Detroit.
All right, I'm just down here today just watching as they go through the name variations. This is pretty much automatic, and it's not a big deal. I just think they should get it over with, so, and just the public just lets folks just do what they got to do and get it over with so we can move forward to the next real step that will be meaningful, and that is on August the 20th at the certification process. And then, of course, 6 days after that, people have to file their request if anybody wants recounts. We'll make that determination at that time.
How are you?
Okay, to the board, we've been presented a relatively lengthy list of write-in candidates for I think all three offices, for mayor, for city council. Were there any for city clerk? In the city of Detroit, for clerk, were there any, or were they all for mayor or council?
No, there was, I have to look. I think they were for clerk, but there was some for council. There's one right in there.
There
is one for
council. Yes, there is. Okay, so we will be determining spelling variations for the office of mayor, clerk, and city council in the city of Detroit. Yes. And there is one for Dearborn.
No, Madam Chair. There are, for every community that conducted the election and they had a write-in candidate, those are all important. So they are all ruling on all of them.
Okay, we will rule on all name variations that have been presented to us by the canvas team. The format that it is okay with my board members that we will follow is we will take action on each and every spelling variation. I will accept a motion to either give the vote to a specific candidate, and I would like you to spell their name at that time, or we would accept a motion to determine that there is sufficient doubt as to the voter intent. Therefore, a vote will not be given to any candidate. So those would be the two motions that would be in order, and we will just go through each and every list. Now, the first page of the document we're working off of is the official write-in candidate list. Are these all the people who filed the intent to write in forms?
Yes.
On the very first page of your document.
Yes.
Then we move directly into.
Who?
So each name that is on this list, we will take up all variations of spelling for each person who was a legal write-in candidate. And some of you may have read all sorts of other names and such, those who were not candidates who filed intent to write in forms with the respective
office. You can ask any questions for me.
Do any of the members of the board canvassers have any input as to the process?
I just have a question. Mm-hmm. Looking at the Dearborn City Council list, it has two spelling variations.
Yes.
Do we know who the lists have, how many votes are with each variation? Mm-hmm.
That's irrelevant to our process at this point.
Okay.
Okay, so are we ready to roll?
Who are you? Excuse me.
Please, and I'm not going to say it's not my thing.
myself.
This is not good for any process that we're trying to engage in.
Let's this is a mafia city.
Let's just
this
sit
be quiet.
Quietly and this let this process continue.
Then, if
all right, let's just let it continue.
No, then don't.
Let's let it continue.
Man, y'all bought. It's
criminal. Spelling
for it. It's supposed to be spelled right to go to anyway, and it's not. Those in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion passes. Next spelling is Mark, M-A-R-K, last name Dugan, D-U-G-G-A-N.
Give it to Mike. Mark don't sound like Mike.
We won't.
Neither one of them. It don't take two, not genius.
How can you have all these variations? That's what I want to know. And we'll call you on, baby. Wayne County Board of Canvassers, they'll be called out. I hope you spend that money in front of the Board of Canvassers.
Voter intent, so no candidate gets a vote. Those in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion passes.
Opposed.
Next name is James Duggan, D-U-G-G-A-N.
Give it to him.
Same motion that we give it with no voters.
Is there support? Those in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion passes. Next name is Jim, J-I-M, Duggan, D-U-G-G-A-N.
Excuse me for one second. Can I take your picture with you?
Properly moved and supported. Those in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Next name is Mike Duggan, D-U-G-G-E-O-N. Properly moved and supported. Those in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Next name, Michael, M-I-C-H-E-A-L, Duggan, D-U-G-G-A-N.
I move those to give the candidate
Duggan. Is there support?
Those
in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, motion passes. Next name, Michael Dudgeon, M-I-C-H-A-E-L, last name D-U-G-E-O-N. Properly moved and supported. Those in favor indicate by saying aye.
Aye.
Next name, Michael T. Period Dudgeon, D. Dated August 13, 2013, hand-delivered. Dear Madam Clerk, I am writing this letter to inform this honorable body of mine and several other candidates' intent to seek a recount of the August 6, 2013 City of Detroit primary election. Moreover, we wanted to remind the Board of its duties pursuant to Public Act 116 at MCL 161.870, MCL 168.869 and MCL 1.8.861, in that your body, it is both required and authorized to investigate the factual allegation contained in the request for recount petition. More specifically, MCL 168.869 states in pertinent part that quote, upon the filing of a petition for recount, the Board of County Canvassers shall be summoned by the clerk of the board and here make an investigation of the facts set forth in the petition. There was emphasis added to investigation of the facts in that sentence. As this board is aware, in the city's last mayoral election in 2009, there were serious chain of custody and security issues which resulted in none of the city's 41,215 absent voter ballots being recountable, along with some 18,646 from the polling precincts, for a total of 59,961 unrecountable ballots. This, as you know, was nearly six times the difference necessary to change the outcome of the contest. This all resulted from serious failures on the part of the city elections officials currently in office today. As multiple recounts will be filed within the six-day time frame for such requests, I wanted to remind this honorable board that MCL 169.870 requires that the facts alleged and contained in the recount petitions be investigated during the recount. In pertinent part, MCL 168.870 prescribes that upon receipt of a recount petition, the board shall have power to issue subpoenas requiring the person in charge thereof to bring before it the ballot boxes used in the election precinct or precincts referred to in the petition, as well as the poll list, tally sheet, statements of return, and such other documents or reports as deemed necessary. Emphasis added. Said board shall safely guard such ballots, poll lists, tally sheets, and returns. Whoever, being so subpoenaed, shall fail to appear or shall fail to produce any such box shall be deemed guilty of a misdemeanor. MCL 168.870. Because we believe that fraud has been committed during this contest, we would respectfully seek to have this body enforce the provisions surrounding such recounts. Respectfully submitted, Tom Barrow, former candidate for mayor. CC Board of Canvassers.
Okay,
do we
have any other business? So we're not adjourned?
No, this meeting will remain open until August 20th, which is the date we will.